So deterrence in the 21st century is completely different than it was in the 20th century, with one big exception. It starts with the nuclear capabilities. That's where deterrence begins. Strategic deterrence has to have a nuclear foundation. Our nuclear forces have to be ready all the time to provide that initial deterrent capability. The entire command has to worry about nuclear first because it is the existential capabilities that threaten our adversaries significantly. Their capabilities threaten us. The deterrent capability starts with them, so we have to focus on nuclear. But in the 21st century, what is different is it's not just one adversary like it was when we had the Soviet Union as an adversary. It's now a multipolar problem with many nations with nuclear weapons and many nations with strategic capability. And it's also multi-domain. So we have to worry about space, cyber, catastrophic activities in each of those domains. We have to worry about the conventional domain. We have adversaries that are looking at integrating nuclear, conventional, space, and cyber all as part of a strategic deterrent. We have to think about strategic deterrence in the same way. We can't just go under the assumption that having 1,550 deployed strategic nuclear weapons under the New START treaty somehow deters all our adversaries. It doesn't. We have to think about all the domains, all of the adversaries, all the capabilities, and focus our attention across the board on all of those. I can't emphasize enough the importance of the people in this command. Sometimes it brings the tears to your eyes when you see the quality of the people that come, that raise their hand, and they want to come and serve our country. I love the fact that we raise our hands and we swear an oath to support and defend the Constitution of the United States. We swear to support and defend an ideal that was written down in a piece of paper over 200 years ago. And that ideal still is what drives the men and women of this country to want to serve. We're different than others. We don't swear allegiance to a crown. We don't swear allegiance to any individual. We swear an oath to an ideal that's written in the Constitution. And the people of this command take that very seriously, and they are just remarkable in what they do.